Hello friends, today I am going to begin the daily current affairs through MCQs for January 30, 2020. Question number 1. With reference to Medical Termination of Pregnancy Act, consider the following statements. Statement number 1. It completely prohibits termination of pregnancy in case fetus is suffering from severe abnormality even after a period of 20 weeks. Statement number 2. The abortion beyond a period of 20 weeks is permitted only if continuing the pregnancy poses a substantial risk to the woman's life. Which of the above statements is or are correct? Option A, 1 only. Option B, 2 only. Option C, both 1 and 2. And option D, neither 1 nor 2. So the answer is 2 only. Now, Medical Termination of Pregnancy Act 1971 is an act to provide for termination of certain pregnancies by registered medical practitioners. Now, pregnancy can be terminated by registered medical practitioner up to 12 weeks of pregnancy and up to 20 weeks with the consent of registered medical practitioner in following two situations. First, the continuance of pregnancy would involve a risk to the life of pregnant woman or of grave injury to her physical or mental health. Or second, there is a substantial risk that if the children were born, it would suffer from such physical or mental abnormalities as to be seriously handicapped. Now let us see Medical Termination of Pregnancy Amendment Bill 2020. Now this bill proposes requirement for opinion of one provider for termination of pregnancy up to 20 weeks of gestation and introducing the requirement of opinion of two providers for termination of pregnancy of 20 to 24 weeks of gestation. The bill enhances the upper gestation limit from 20 to 24 weeks for a special category of women, which will be defined in the amendments to the MTP rules and would include: first, vulnerable women, including the survivors of rape, victims of incest, and other vulnerable women like differently abled women, minors, etc. Now, the upper gestation limit not to apply in case of substantial fetal abnormalities which are diagnosed by medical board. Bill also says that name and other particulars of woman whose pregnancy has been terminated shall not be revealed except to a person authorized in any law for the time being in force. Now, question number 2. Consider the following statements with respect to Nagoba Jatra. First statement: it is a tribal festival celebrated by Mesaram clan of Gond tribes. Statement 2: it is organized across various states during the whole year. Which of the above statements is or are correct? Option A, 1 only. Option B, 2 only. Option C, both 1 and 2. Option D, neither 1 nor 2. So the answer is 1 only. Now, Nagoba Jatra is a tribal festival held in Kislapur village, Adilabad district, Telangana. It is the second biggest tribal carnival and is celebrated by Mesaram clan of Gond tribes for 10 days. This is a news because it has recently been concluded. The religious season for Gonds and Kolams gets started in December and then they embark on pilgrimages to distant forests and jungles wherein the temples of respective clan deities are present. So the pilgrimage party comprises of the entire clan in the given agency area. Tribal people from Maharashtra, Chandigarh, Odisha, Madhya Pradesh belonging to the Mesaram clan offer the prayers at this festival. Thousands of tribal people from Maharashtra, Chhattisgarh, Odisha, Karnataka, Jharkhand and Madhya Pradesh belonging to the Mesaram clan offer prayer at the festival of Nagoba. Now question number 3. With respect to African cheetah, consider the following statements. Statement 1. They are classified as critically endangered under the IUCN status. Statement 2. they will be reintroduced at Kuno Wildlife Sanctuary in Madhya Pradesh. Now, which of these statements are true? Option A, one only. Option B, two only. Option C, both one and two. And option D, neither one nor two. So the answer is two only. Now, Supreme Court has lifted its 7-year stay on a proposal to introduce African cheetahs from Namibia into Indian habitat. So the plan was to revive the Indian cheetah population. Background is, in May 2012, Supreme Court had stalled the plan to initiate the foreign cheetahs into Kuno Palpur Sanctuary in Madhya Pradesh, fearing that they may come into the conflict with an effort to reintroduce lions into the same sanctuary. Now let us see some important things about African and Asian cheetah. So the IUCN status of African cheetah is vulnerable and not critically endangered. The IUCN status of Asian cheetah is critically endangered. In habitat, African cheetah are around 7,000 are found in wild, whereas less than 50 cheetahs, Asian cheetahs are left on earth. Now something about Kuno Palpur Wildlife Sanctuary. It is located in Madhya Pradesh and was a site to implement the Asiatic Lion Reintroduction Project. Now it is a proposed site for African cheetah reintroduction in India. In 2019, the status of wildlife sanctuary changed to Kuno National Park. Now question number 4. Consider the following statements with respect to Bhuvan 3.0. Statement 1. Bhuvan is ISRO's internet portal and an app which provides visualization services and earth observation data to users in public domain. Statement 2. The government agencies use this platform to share and host their data as per their requirements, enabling specific applications of their choice. Which of the above statements are true? Option A, one only. Option B, two only. Option C, both one and two. And option D, neither one nor two. So the answer is both one and two. Now before going to Bhuvan, let us understand Bhuvan 3.0. Now under Bhuvan 3.0, ISRO will collaborate with Gram Panchayat members to understand their data requirement. The portal will function with the help of technology of ISRO. And the project will run for 2 years. The portal aims at helping village development planning process under the Ministry of Panchayat. Now basically, what is the Bhuvan project? Bhuvan is a satellite application that is powered by ISRO. It allows the users to explore 2D and 3D representation of the earth. Besides that, the portal also services several users for their remote sensing application need. Government agencies use this platform to share and host their data as per their requirements, enabling specific applications of their choice. Now recently, Ministry of AYUSH collaborated with Bhuvan portal for a yoga related app. Now question number 5. NTPC has recently announced to assist which West African country for development of solar power project? Option A, Liberia. Option B, Benin. Option C, Togo. And option D, Ghana. So answer is Togo. Now the state owned electricity PSU, NTPC Limited, has been announced as the project management consultant for development of 300 megawatt of solar power project in West African country of Togo. Now the letter of engagement was recently signed between the country and the Indian PSU in this regard. This is the first time a country has sought assistance from NTPC under the India-led International Solar Alliance. As per the agreement, Togo will not incur the cost of the project, while NTPC will recover the project cost through bids. Now question number 6. Which state has recently launched a virtual police station under its flagship 5T initiative? Option A, Kerala. Option B, Telangana. Option C, Odisha. Option D, Bihar. So the answer is Odisha. Now, Chief Minister of Odisha, Naveen Patnaik, has recently launched a virtual police station under the state's flagship 5D initiative. Now, Chief Minister has also launched two other innovative projects of Odisha Police called Road Accident Case Document Module and Medico-Legal Opinion System. Now, the virtual police station will enable the citizens to directly lodge FIR online without having to visit the police station. The two other applications will help in downloading the required documents and online medical examination reports of accident victims. Now, 5D program was introduced by Chief Minister of Odisha in 2019. The 5D's aim at achieving progress through transparency, teamwork, technology, time, and transformation. Now, this is the first of such type of program in the country. Question number 7. With respect to national level search services launched by NCRB, consider the following statements. Statement 1. It will help the citizens in searching missing persons and generating vehicle NOC. Second, this is first such nationwide service in India. Now, which of the following statements are true? Option A, 1 only. Option B, 2 only. Option C, both 1 and 2. Option D, neither 1 nor 2. So, the answer is both 1 and 2. Now, NCRB launched police-related citizen-centric services on CCTNS platform. These online services will help the citizens in searching their missing persons and generating vehicle NOC. Now, the service can be accessed through digitalpolicecitizenservices.gov.in portal or through a link in the existing digital police portal. So far, such services are being provided through the state citizens portal, and it is the first time that these are being launched centrally. Now, question number 8. Consider the following statements regarding the enforcement and monitoring guidelines for sand mining 2020. Option 1. Statement 1. It directs the states to carry out river and sand beach audits. Statement 2. It recommends for sale and purchase of sand online. Statement 3. According to the guidelines, no riverbed mining will be allowed during the monsoon. Now, which of the above statements are true? Option A, 1 and 2 only. Option B, 2 and 3 only. Option C, 1 and 3 only. Option D, 1, 2 and 3. So, the answer is 2 and 3 only. Now, the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change has for the first time released the guidelines to monitor and check illegal sand mining in the country, which is called the Enforcement and Monitoring Guidelines for the Sand Mining 2020. Now, these guidelines directions the states to carry out river audits. It doesn't include sand beach audits, hence statement 1 is incorrect. Second, put detailed survey reports of all mining areas online and in public domain. Third, conduct replenishment studies of riverbeds. Fourth, constantly monitor mining with drones, aerial surveys, ground surveys. Fifth, set up a dedicated task force at district levels. Sixth, to carry out a detailed survey for quantification of minerals and demand and supply of riverbed material through market survey, including future demand for next 5 years. Now, the guidelines also push for online sale and purchase of sand and other riverbed material to make the process transparent. Besides this, it also proposes night surveillance of mining activity through night vision drones. It also prohibits the riverbed mining during the monsoon season. So that is all in news today. Thank you so much. If you like the video, please click the subscribe button and press the notification bell. Please comment and share the video. Thanks a lot.